So what I'm saying, people of God, as children of the Most High God, you see the reason why the Holy Ghost have me to teach such a powerful message pertaining to us here that is calling upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ is to show that many times we are struggling as even a newcomer, or as you know, funny life is, people of God, as a newcomer, somebody that just start to serve the Lord Jesus Christ and want to serve him and don't know much about him and don't understand what he's about, name it and what of you, and people of God, get what I'm saying.
Yes.
It takes ability to learn so much about God. What is ability? Ability is, my God Almighty, the effort that you are going to push out. Come on, people.
Yes.
Ability is, my God Almighty, you, whatever you are doing, you must mean it. Come on, people. I feel the Holy Ghost. Ability is what, people of God, when you make up your mind, you have to have a made up mind.
Yes.
Ability is when, my God Almighty, you're going to tell yourself, I'm finished with that and I'm ready for this. What is this? The things of God. Come on, people. And that is the sin. Come on, people.
Right.
You know why that is sin? Listen to this revelation. You know why that is sin? Notice when, my God Almighty, bleach, my God Almighty, at that of bleach touch your clothes or we destroy it. Bleach, my God Almighty. Notice, my God Almighty, if a woman having her menses and she sit down and didn't know when it was coming and it happened to go on the clothes, look how terribly it looked, people of God, and even bring shame to that woman. Because that is what we don't want. When you finish with that, let it go back to who it belonged to, that wicked old Satan, that Lucifer. Come on, give God glory.
Yes, God. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Come on, people. It takes a makeup mind. People of God, this is powerful. I'm telling you, the Holy Spirit of me, my God Almighty.
Mighty God. Hallelujah.
When, my God Almighty, when, people of God, if we really and truly want to get in the things of God, I don't know about nobody, but I tell some of you, people of God, that when I start out with the Lord Jesus Christ, I wasn't playing, and today I am not playing. Many Christians start out playing and still playing. That is the reason why I don't speak and said you need to play your part. No. Playing is playing. Doing is doing. Come on, people. Many things the Holy Spirit of God have me to be careful how I talk. Many things he wants, if I'm telling his people things, I must tell him what he is saying, not what I am thinking and doing. Come on, people. Not what the flesh want. You don't play your part with God. You do your part with, like all God do, you do. Come on, people. Why you think people, look at human being, what they say, monkey do. Come on, people.
Monkey say, monkey do.
If monkey can say and monkey can do, what about us with God? Come on, people. We are to say what God is saying and do what God is doing. Come on, people.
Amen.
Come on, people.
Amen.
A child of the Most High God that come to the Lord Jesus Christ, he done, especially these last days, I can tell you something, people of God, there's a power that come in the midst. It is like, my God Almighty, sponge. It lap up and it sop up, and that's the power God want us to gain in our midst.
Mighty God, hallelujah. Jesus.
That's the type of power God wants for us to gain in the midst, people.
Thank you, Lord.
People of God, we are dealing with new beginning. Come on, people.
Amen.
Get rid of the whole and bring in the new. Write that down, Minister Gay. Get rid of the whole and bring in the new.
Yes.
New beginning. For you to get rid of the old and bring in the new as a child of God. As a child of God.
Amen.
Yes, amen.
People of God, let me say this to you all. That is the reason why these last days, those that are very serious for the Lord Jesus Christ, it don't take no, my God Almighty, it don't have to take you, no, my God Almighty, long time for you to start working for God. Come on, talk to me.
That's right. Yes, that's right.
If you have the ability, if you have the made up mind and have the ability, the ability is like, my God Almighty, a person that go to college and get their what? They get their what? What you get from your what?
Degree.
You get your degree. Go to high school, you get your diploma. Go to go to college, you get your degree. Come on, people.
Amen.
Yes.
Did you know that on earth here, you have children, my God Almighty? They are so educated. That what you call it? They come on, people. You educators, help me. There's a thing about like my life. Sister Merlin was here, she would just tap in, bop like that. Like Sister Merlin have a little grandbaby. That little baby IQ. Come on, people. She have a very IQ. Come on, talk to me.
High IQ.
Thank you. The baby have a high IQ. She don't talk, when she talking, she don't talk like a 2 year old. She talk like a 6. People have got a child talk so big.
Yeah,
intelligent. She learned the computer. When Sister Merlin, them try to give her a baby phone, she said no. She know the baby phone different from the adult phone. Come on, talk to me. She said, no, she don't want the baby phone. And people of God don't care what you're doing, she's not taking it. And she learned the phone on her very own.
My God.
That's how that little baby girl is. She go, and when she going on it, she going for a little baby game, them a little A, B, C, D, da, 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 name it. She tap in, she know how to go in and get those things. You cannot fool that little 2 to 3 year old baby, you cannot. Collier, you cannot fool Collier. And there are many babies. You ever notice, my God Almighty, many children, my God Almighty, they have them on the television. If you should tap in, my God Almighty, on YouTube, you would see them, my God Almighty, doing many things. Come on, people. Children, my God Almighty, spelling as small as they is. They talk, they can tell you how many prime minister from the day one till now. They can tell you the president. They can tell you the name. They can call countries. They can do this, they can do that. If it's so with the natural, what do you think about the spiritual?
Hey.
Yes.
Don't you think the spiritual is more powerful? Come on, people.
Yes. Yes, it is, yes.
Don't you think the spirit? No, look at somebody like myself here. My God Almighty, I didn't able to gain education. What am I doing talking to all you that are educators? What am I doing? It's because, my God Almighty, I make up my mind to have that ability to do the will of God. Come on, people.
That's right. Perseverance. Yes, perseverance.
Perseverance. Come on, people.
Amen.
It takes perseverance. Many people said they love the Lord God Almighty. But still yet, as your queen, my God Almighty, they turn away from him. And they're going to do something that is called S-I-N, sin. Come on, people.
Right.
To really love him, you will please him. Come on, talk to me.
You'll keep his commandment.
Yeah.
You will keep his commandment. Come on, people.
Yeah.
What I'm trying to say,
amen.
If a little baby, my God Almighty, can able to have a high IQ, why can't you have, my God Almighty, a deepness to want to do for the Lord Jesus Christ? Come on, talk to me.
Hallelujah. Yes. Mighty God, Jesus.
It is available. It is available for every single person.
Thank you, Lord God.
You might not, my God Almighty, have a calling upon your life to be, my God Almighty, all the 5, my God Almighty, hallelujah. What you would say? Pastors, teachers, prophet, the fivefold ministry. You might not have it on you to be a deacon, minister. Hold on, Jesus. Jesus.
Conference unmuted.
I'm back. The conference was muted. You might not, Michael Almighty, be a deacon, a minister, name it whatever, but you might just be what? Somebody that go into church. Let me say this to you all. You have church goers and you have children of God. Come on, talk to me.
Right.
Many people don't believe that. Many people believe that because they see church full and everybody come to church, everybody is safe. No. But the only thing can prove that, to show that many don't save, just let the trumpet blow and then you will see who and who was saved. Just let the trumpet blow, then you will know who and who was safe. Let me say this to you, to us all here, people of God. Let us not miss it, either in death or in resurrection. Let us not miss it.
Amen.
Let us not miss it.
God.
Let us not miss it.
Jesus, not to miss it.
Let us not miss it. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes, Holy Spirit.
Let us not miss it. People of God, we have, my God, we can, my God Almighty, do things to please God. Stop. We can do things to please God and stop grieving God. Stop grieving God. He wants to do so much for you and I, but because we keep grieving him, the Holy Spirit that he have here in earth cannot come in and operate for us.
Right.
It is the Holy, listen to me, for us here on earth, it is the Holy Spirit that make the way. Come on, people.
Amen.
The angel, let me tell you something, people of God. The very angel that Michael Almighty here are calling upon, angel that here many people calling upon, angel that God himself has created, they cannot operate without the Holy Spirit. Cannot.
Right.
God, listen to me. God himself could not operate without the Holy Spirit. Come on, talk to me. Because he created the Holy Spirit as a human in spirit to work for him, because he will not come down here on earth as God. Come on, talk to me and do it.
Amen.
He will not. The angel depends on the Holy Spirit. Come on, people.
Yes.
Because it is so plain for us to see when Jesus said, when I go up, I will send the Comforter. Without, if we don't have the Holy Spirit in the midst, people of God, what happened to many of us? We are miserable. And the Holy Spirit cannot work without righteousness and holiness. Cannot.
Right.
You want to see God work for you? Make up in your mind to get rid of the foolishness.
Yes.
Get rid of the bickering, the complaining, the this and the that. Name it, people of God. You don't need that. You need to come and do for the Lord Jesus. That's what we need, people. You have my God Almighty in the midst. If you look, my God Almighty, if some of you should go on YouTube, which I believe you do, you would even see some little children preaching. Come on, talk to me.
It's true. Yes.
You would see some little children. I saw a little baby boy. This little boy could not be more than maybe 5. He end up die. And I know for sure that child didn't have to die, but because more or less he probably didn't have somebody in the midst to pray him through and help him through, but God used him in a way before he died, the little boy. It was sent to the phone. I think it was sometime last year I read it. And this little baby boy was talking. He's talking and said how much he loved Jesus, and he know that when he die, he's going to the Lord Jesus. and he's going. And I mean, his conversation was like a blowing mind conversation. It was a mind blowing. Thank you. It was a mind blowing, people of God, when he was speaking. And I'm looking at it to say, if a little baby child like that can speak that way, what about us as grown people? Come on, people. What about us? Keep grieving the heart of God. Keep doing things that is not pleasing in the sight of God. God don't want for us to keep doing these things. Come on, people. It is not for us to keep doing these things. We have to have a made up mind. Because I rise up to tell you, when I was in sin, I can talk about myself. When I was in sin and was out there, and now that I come in, it is far way different. To me, it is the best. I don't know about any other. I don't see any life that is, people of God, can somebody find sweetness in life when there is suffering and struggling going on? Yes, you can. What you talking about now? You can find it, because as long as you have Jesus Christ in the midst, as long as the Holy Spirit is in the midst, there is nothing sweeter than that. Oh, you think, my God Almighty, I able to pray all these prayer? Oh, you think I able to do all these things and going through all kind of suffering? How you think I do it? You think I just do it because, my God Almighty, oh, this, that and the other? No. It's because, people of God, I made up my mind. You have to have a made up mind for the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Some people come to the Lord Jesus Christ because they want to do what? Prostitute him.
Yes.
What am I talking about? What am I talking about when I said because they want to prostitute him? They want to play game. They think their little mind can, my God Almighty, fool him. They think that he don't know about their mind. Because you see, some people claim that is their mother create them, is not God. That's the only set of people that's supposed to think like that. But if we know that we were created by God, we are not to think like that as if our little mind can fool God. No.
That's right.
Leave that to the ignorant. Leave that to those that, my God Almighty, their children grow up because their parents tell them that there is no God. Leave that to them.
That's right.
Let us, my God Almighty, prove to them and show them that there is a God. By whatever God to do in our life, when God do it in our life, then the gates of hell cannot prevail over us. Come on, people.
Yes, amen, hallelujah.
The gates of hell cannot prevail. We have the Holy Spirit, the Comforter. As my God Almighty, a child of the Most High God, you don't even need. The Bible tells us, people of God, that somebody find it. Having the Holy Spirit, my God Almighty, you don't even need nobody, because he will teach you all things. Come on, talk to me. If you really and truly make up your mind, he will teach you all things. He will teach you all things. Come on, people.
Come on.
He will teach you all things, people.
Amen.
If you only open up, my God Almighty, for him to teach you. Cry out for whatever, my God Almighty, you believe, you know it's a blockage. Because from the moment you welcome in, you must have that, my God Almighty, sense of humor to know that you're operating the same way you used to. And that is the reason why he can't able to come in. Come on, people.
Amen.
Look at some people. Many people see me. You all remember the lady, the young miss that right on the line? Apostle, can you pray for me so that I pray I be like you? The young miss said, can you pray for me so that I can be like you? Some people will ask God for some kind of things. But when God started to move in for them to get it, they start to cry out and said, the devil is doing this and this is happening and that is happening and da da da. You see, sometimes it's not the devil. Sometimes it's a test you're taking. Come on, talk to me.
Hey, that's right. Yeah.
I said sometimes it's not the devil. Sometimes it's a test you're taking. Bless God. 1 John 2:27. Go ahead and read it. Read it.
But you have received the Holy Spirit, and he lives within you, so you don't need anyone to teach you what is true. For the Spirit teaches you everything you need to know, and what he teaches is true. It is not a lie. So just as he has taught you, remain in fellowship with Christ.
You hear that? You have to get rid of the hanky-panky. You have to get rid of sin. Get rid of what has been a blockage in your life all the time before you come to the Lord Jesus Christ. You cannot be walking on the same road. You have to get off the busy road and get on the lonely road.
Amen.
You have to. Friends you used to have, you will realize that you don't have them anymore. That's a change. Things you see you used to do, you will realize that you don't do it no more. That's a change. The way you used to talk, you will find you're not talking like that. That's a change.
Amen.
Name it. But if you see yourself doing the same thing, I rise up to tell you, Jesus don't enter in as yet.
Come on now. Right.
I said, if you see yourself still cursing bad word, if you see yourself still, my God Almighty, fighting, carrying on, using the same all, doing the same all, name it and one of you, Jesus don't enter yet. When you open up your mouth to say you're my God Almighty, doing the confession prior, you were only fooling yourself. It is a lip thing. It's not coming from the heart. It's not coming from the heart. You have to persevere and say, my God Almighty, enough is enough and I don't want this kind of life. Because I rise up to tell you, when you speak against Satan, he have to take away his little filthy self. But when you speak the things that he speak, he will continue living with you.
Amen.
When you continue speaking what Satan speak. But when you don't, my God Almighty, you see, when I just got saved, let me say something to you all. When I just got saved, I never forget when I give myself to the Lord Jesus Christ. Two things was a stronghold on my life: sex and bad words. Dirty language, dirty talking, name it and whatever. Those were stronghold upon my life. And what you all need to get and understand, I never forget, after knowing that I got saved in the house, I go to the church and I got baptized. I was my God Almighty one day. Then you see, when it happened, you know, people of God, and this is how it go, you know. The Lord will allow things to happen in the midst of people. And you will even prove to this, to whoever it happened in the midst of, to see how much they are with you or not. Come on, talk to me.
Amen.
And it happened, my God Almighty, that I was right there, sitting down one day in the yard, at the front of my yard. And a young miss came that, you know, I happened to meet her at the church that I start to go to. And never know that the Lord want me to go to that church just to get baptized. Come on, people, talk to me. I said he wanted for me just to go to the church to get baptized. So I went to the church, got baptized, met with the young miss. came back. Day passed, weeks passed, name it. One day I was sitting down. And while I was there sitting down, I believe I was talking on the phone or something. And something just irritate my spirit. And the same way I cursed the bad word, they just come out like brrr. I said, oh my God, Jesus, Jesus. People of God, what if you hear what I'm saying? When the bad word come out of my mouth, I did not stay quiet. I said, oh my God, Jesus, 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 have mercy, Jesus. Come on, people. Why? Because I have the ability to push forward. Those that don't have the ability to push forward, if they curse bad words, if they do whatever, they don't, my God, it doesn't matter to them. It is like nothing to them. Come on, talk to me. If you find yourself doing that, it shows that Jesus is not on the inside of you yet.
That's right. Yes,
he's not. Because I rise up to tell you, when Jesus come in, nobody can push him out unless you do it. Only you. The devil cannot push him out. Only you.
Yeah.
I catch myself. And I started to, people of God, in a quick and a second, right before the youngest, I was like, sorry, my sister, sorry, sister, sorry, sister. And I was there praying. I said, oh, Jesus, have mercy, Jesus, forgive me. People of God, from that day until today, I don't curse bad word again. From 2003, come on, people, in the summer, June. I hear June 11th, Lord God Almighty. Hallelujah!
Glory!
2003, June 11th. Come on, people. I don't curse another bad word until today, and the devil not going to let me curse any. Come on, people. And what you all need to understand, I was an entertainer. I used to sing out there, going to club, going to dance, going to this, going to that. I know it all. Come on, people. I used to be out there, but none of those always follow me. Why? Because I have a made up mind. Some people come to God to get what they can get. Some people come to God because they want to be saved. Come on, people.
Right.
One of you all get that one a while ago. Some people come to God to be saved. Some come to get what they can get. Write that one down.
Yes.
Come on, people. What do you come to God for? To be saved or to get what you can get? Come on. What do you come to God for? Are you sick and tired of being in sin? Or you just want to play a little party with him? No, I'm sorry. He will not come to your party. You cannot give him an invitation. He don't take those kind of invitation. Jesus Christ do not take those kind of invitation. The Holy Spirit do not take those kind of invitation. When you're writing an invitation to him, you have to write, goodbye world, I'm no longer with you. Goodbye sin, I'm no longer with you. I made up my mind to go God's way all of the time. Come on, people.
Amen.
Those are the invitation he takes. I want you all hear what I'm saying. And the only way you can give God such an invitation, you have to what? Have a made up mind. He see the heart. We cannot hide from God. If you want to do the same thing over and over and over, that is called what? Presumptuous. Come on, talk to me.
Amen.
Many, my God Almighty, I said, you have people that will make mistakes, and you have people that have a presumptuous behavior. Come on. I wonder if you all hear what I'm saying, people.
Yeah.
And God knows the difference. He knows when you made up your mind, and he knows when you have a presumptuous behavior.
Mm-hmm.
We cannot hide from God. None of us can hide from him. He is God. He is God and God alone. Come on, people. That's why he alone sits on the throne. He is God and God alone. That's why he alone sits on the throne. We cannot play with him. We cannot play with him. I tell people this. If you are serving God, serve him. If you want to please the devil, go and stay with the devil. But don't think we have to understand we cannot play anky panky party. Come on, talk to me.
Oh, no.
It's not about no anky panky party.
No.
God don't play. God is not a God that play. He do. Come on, people. He do. And in his doing, he's very true. Come on, people. God, talk to me. In his doings, he's very true.
Yes,
he don't play game.
No.
We cannot play game with him. He don't play. Many people today are playing church. God is not into the playing church.
Yeah.
When we were small children, we play room for rent, supply with me. When I run out, then you run in. Anyone on the line remember that game?
Yes, amen.
Yes.
And look into it. If we want to, my God Almighty, think that our little mind can deceive my God Almighty God when we are playing those kind of game. You think God don't know it?
Yes, he knows it.
Today we are, tomorrow we call. Today we are, tomorrow we call. Today you are, tomorrow. Come on, people. Room for rent, supply with me. Satan run in. Satan run out. Jesus run in. Room for rent, supply with me. Satan come in. Jesus come out. I rise up to tell you, he's not the kind of God that you can confuse. He don't play confused game.
No.
And I rise up to tell you, when a person that behave like this, Jesus is not in. It's just the Holy Spirit trying to come in the midst. But the Holy Spirit can't able. That is the reason why some people say, oh, I feel a little tingling. Oh, I feel a little pimples come upon my skin. That is for those that is playing. Come on, talk to me.
Amen.
When you can feel the rushing water moving on the inside, you know that Jesus is inside, even if you don't have the speaking of tongues.
Yes.
You will feel the living water bubbling up. Come on, people.
Yes.
Those that are playing with God only can feel the little pimples and the little bubbling and the little brushing, and it's like a wind blowing on you. And, ooh, I feel a little chill. I feel a little this. I feel. You don't need that.
No, goosebumps.
You need, my God Almighty, to feel the power of God. My God Almighty moving on the inside. Come on, people.
Amen.
Moving on the inside. That's even so. When you feel it, you might not, my God Almighty, feel tongues coming up. But if you start to feel tongues, it tongues start to push out like a rushing mighty wind.
Okay.
Come on, people.
Okay.
Being with the Lord Jesus Christ is no anky panky plaything. It best, my God Almighty, who want to stay with the devil, best they stay with the devil. Who want to be with Jesus, best you be with Jesus. Come on, people.
Yeah.
You see, whenever I'm preaching, teaching, and talking, I don't play. I speak it just as how the Lord want me to bring it forth. Come on, people. This is a very serious walk with God. I said this is a very serious walk with God. This is no joke thing. It is not for us to play church. It is for us to get serious. Don't play church. Do church. Come on, people.
Amen.
You don't need to play God. Do God. Come on, people.
Amen.
Get out of the plane. Don't bother with the room for rent supply with me, because I rise up to tell you, when you run him out, he don't just force himself in. It don't happen like that. If you do the confession prior and you have a made up, you see, that is the thing about it, people of God. And many people think that listen to me, I am an apostle from the Most High God. That's a calling on my life. And this is a very heavy calling, and I don't play with sin.
Right, amen.
I do not play with sin. I'm very radical for my God.
Amen.
Very radical for him. If we are serving God, let us serve him. If you're not serving God, don't try to, my God Almighty. It's just like some people. You ever notice some people, my God Almighty, they are as broke as a church mouse. But when they see rich people, they hop into the company of rich people. They will take their, my God Almighty, mortgage. They will take their car note money. They will take everything, insurance money, everything. Buy the most bling bling. Buy the this. They will even go and pay them on a car that look big and rich, just to be in the company of rich people. And they are not rich. Come on, people.
Hey,
that is how some people is with God. Want to play? Come on, people. Go into restaurant. You know, when you go into the restaurant and order the food, my God Almighty, what you think happen? You know for sure that when you pay for the food, you're not going to have no money to pay to even, if you don't drive, you might have to walk. Come on, talk to me. I'm not saying that God can't have his people them to live good and can able to go into whatever restaurant, name it. I'm not talking about that, so nobody don't look at it like that. I'm talking about people that want to pretend as if they are when they are not.
That's it.
Yeah.
Playing the game. And don't know that it is going to have what brings shame. When you play the game, it brings shame. Come on, people. But when you do, my God Almighty, what is right, then you will have right beside you the Lord Jesus Christ. Give him glory. Playing game will bring you shame, but having the Lord Jesus Christ in the midst, you will have him in, my God Almighty, beside you, right at your side. He will present himself, my God Almighty, the Holy Spirit, and you will become friend. You see, people don't understand. The Holy Spirit is, you hear what him, you hear what it hear, it name? You hear what him name? The Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
You don't even need to put righteousness in the midst of your talking. Just say the Holy Spirit. Because when somebody lives in holy, righteousness causes you to become holy. Only righteousness. Only righteousness can have you to become holy. What is righteousness? Everything you are doing, you are being so careful because you don't want to grieve the Spirit of God. That is righteousness, people. When you're doing right, when you want to live a righteous life in the sight of the Lord Jesus Christ. Come on, people.
Amen.
That's the only way you can please God. You have to get on the road of righteousness before you start to say you are holy. Come on, people. You have to get to a place where you know for sure you know good and you know bad. Come on, people. You have to, my God Almighty, have, my God Almighty, something that is called a conscience on the inside. And whenever, my God Almighty, you commit wrong, that conscience be convicted. Come on, people.
Yes, amen.
If you are doing wrong and you're not, your conscience have not been convicted, right there, Jesus Christ is not on the inside. He's not. It's a vain imagination going on. Vain imagination. Come on, talk to me.
Amen.
That is what is called vain imagination. You are fooling yourself. Living for the Lord Jesus Christ is not no dally house. Get out of the dally house. We used to pretend. The people that play dally house are people that are pretend that they are mothers and they are fathers. Come on, talk to me. You pretend, my God Almighty. You even will take a little, a real baby and pretend that you're the mother for that baby. As well as we used to use the little doll. Come on, people, use the little doll. And that's the baby. But you have the mother and you have the real mother and the real father. That's how it is. We are real, but the life that we are living is false. Come on, people. Everybody stuck? We have to, for us to get that new beginning. Come on, people. We cannot play church. No playing of church. And we don't need to, I don't care. God understand. God, that's another talking with some of us. Oh, yes, I know I did wrong, but God understand. Thank God, God, that he's not like man. Leave me alone and da da da. And you start to curse and you start to carry on, putting more sin on sin. Somebody see you doing something. I said, oh, could you behave like that? And you said you're a child of God. Don't you say you get saved? Why are you talking like that? You're talking the same way you used to be out there. You're cursing bad words. You're doing this, you're doing that. Da, da, da. Don't you stay? Why are you still doing all these things? Why you say, oh, you know, I need to pray. Oh, God, pray for me. Pray for me. Don't you know, pray for me. Help me, Jesus. When you behave like that, it shows that you're getting humble. Come on, talk to me. You really and truly want to live for the Lord Jesus Christ. But you know the matter with some of us? Some of us believe that, my God Almighty, God loves us so much that he's going to stay with us in our mess. Some of us believe that God loves us so much that the things that we used to do, we must still do it. And then when we're ready, we can brush off. Like I said, when I used to be small, I used to, my God, love to steal out my mother's meat. I was a little kitchen rat.
Yeah.
I was a little kitchen rat. I wasn't the bedroom. I wasn't the living room. I wasn't nowhere else. I was just the kitchen rat. Because I used to be very greedy and I always like to steal out food. And when I steal food out, people of God, and when you see I put that food, I don't know how I manage with this tongue. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, to know that you are God to help me. Because this tongue could have burned off already and come to nothing.
Yeah.
I always steal the food, and when my mother looking, I throw it in my mouth, and people of God, I don't know, I swallow that hot food, and I will squeeze my eyes and my throat will be on fire, every part of me. It's the mercy of God that helped me. Because I was a little kid, and then I would just wipe off my mouth. And when my mother called, talk, I would, if the food going down, I would pretend, I know to pretend to, what's the matter with you? Oh, I try to swallow, maybe my speech go and lie beside it. And that's the thing about us, some of us are lying to ourselves, say we're serving God. We are lying to ourselves, we're not lying to God. We are not lying to God, people. We are lying to ourselves. We are pretenders. When some of us behind closed door, we do everything that we used to. But when we come out in the open of people, we pretend. We cannot hide from God. We cannot. Come on, people. The comforter see everything. The comforter report to the angel, and the angel report to God.
Yes.
Come on, people.
Yes.
The comforter see everything. That is the reason why we can't see the comforter. We can only feel the comforter. The comforter see everything and report to the angel, and the angel slide on the ladder. You see, when the angels them coming down, people of God, you see when they, when you hear, when you don't hear it, but you see when the angel, this is how angel move. And this that I'm doing is when they go up and come down in a, oh God Almighty, I tell you, in a shift. Come on, people, in a shift.
Yes.
Not no shift and no second. In a shift. Look at the hand. Look at the hand of the clock. The hand of the clock have to go on second.
Yeah.
It go on minute. It go on minute and it change to second. That is the reason why God timing is different from ours.
Amen.
Our time and His time is different. He move in a shift. By the time you by all right, if God said if all right, no, look at this. That is the reason. Can I teach a little something, people of God?
Yes.
That is the reason why with Elijah and Elisha, when both of them was here on earth in those days as prophet. And when Elisha found out that Elijah is going to cart up, what do you think Elisha do? Elisha decide not to take his eyes from off him.
Right.
Come on, people.
Amen, yeah.
Because if he was to even take it, if people, can you imagine how he tried not to quint? Can you imagine the tension, my God Almighty, that Elisha have to go through just to see his father, Elijah, going up so that he can catch that mantle?
Yes.
It was a perseverance.
Yes.
It was an ability that he shows.
Yeah.
He made up his mind. When the prophets them or whoever come around, oh Elijah, don't you know that your father is going to cart up? Oh, why don't you shut your mouth? I know it. You don't need to tell me. I know it. Why? Because you see, because what? When he tell them to, you don't have to tell me, just ease off. He don't want them to do what? Distract him. Because the time they're going to listen, he's going to stand up and listen to them and pay them attention. Elijah might just caught up and he miss it. Come on, people.
Amen, yes.
So right there, he have to, my God Almighty, keep his eyes on him.
Yes.
I don't know if you're all getting and understand what I'm talking about, people.
Amen. Yeah.
He had was to keep his eyes on him.
Yeah.
Because God move in a shift. Come on, people. Listen to me. God do not quick. And he do not, what is the next word I tell you all? God move in a shift. We are the one that are quick to do things and the devil switch. Come on, people. The reason why Satan cannot quick is because he can only go to and fro. Come on, people. We as children of God, because we are so fleshy and we always believe that we know and we this and we that, we will be very quick to do things. That's why the Bible said be slow to speak and quick to hear. Quick belong to us. Come on, people.
Right.
Quick belong to us, and we can be quick to rebuke as well. You're quick to rebuke when you see you do something or you sin or you make a mistake. Yes, we can make mistake because we are in the flesh and the devil can tempt us. Come on, people. But whenever you see you do something, be quick, my God Almighty, to do what? Rebuke it. Repent. Turn. God will do things in a shift. And when you see something done in a shift, people of God, you cannot change it. Come on, talk to me. It only takes God to change whatever shift he makes. Come on, people. Only God can change that shift. And when we are quick to do things, we can only repent about it and God will change it in a shift. When God shift, he turn away the left and give us the right. Come on, people. He turn away the wrong and give us the right. Come on, people. God turn things. Come on, people. God turn things. That's why he shift. That is the reason why he shift, because he's a God on time. Come on, people, in whatever he's doing. He's an on time God. He's always on. Listen to me, not in, not to, not far. He's an on. He's an always on time God. That means if you have him in the midst, he will stay on you. Come on, people. His eyes will stay on you.
Amen.
Because he's an on time God. Come on, people. He's an on time God. Get that in your midst. So, children of God, it is for us to do the things that is pleasing my God Almighty in his sight. Live for the Lord Jesus Christ. Live to please him. Stop pleasing man. Man will fail, but God will never fail.
Hallelujah.
Stop live to please people and please God. Stop grieving him. Come on, people. Stop grieving God.
Thank you, Jesus.
We are to stop grieve God. Stop grieving God. And please God. That's what we need to do. Stop grieving God and please God.
Yes.
We are doing it too much. That is the reason why when we keep doing things over and over, what he said he will leave us to our reprobate mind. When God tell us that our mind are reprobate, it means we are acting like as if we are animals that have no sense. We have no sense, no conscience, no nothing. Nothing is operating us that is good. And when God's spirit have to leave us, that is too sad. If we are going through something, it don't mean that the spirit of God leave us. It means that he want to take us on a level with him.
Hallelujah.
All we need to do is to say, Lord, Help me to go through and to make it to the end, to complete this. Help me to go through and to complete. The reason why I can speak like this, people of God, I have been there.
Amen.
The amount of tests that I have to take to reach where I am, you all would not believe it. You wouldn't understand it. You would have to go through it. But I don't wish these things for you. Because people of God, just imagine serving the Lord Jesus Christ, going through all these things, so many years. Come on, people. I have my time serving the Lord from 2003 until now. How long is it? Can somebody help me? 14 years going to 15. Which one of them? Am I at 14 or 15?
14.
14 years and some months.
14 and
yeah. 14 years and some months. Can you understand what that means, people of God? That is the reason why God is getting me ready to possess Florida. Come on, people.
Hey, thank you, Jesus.
He's getting ready for me to possess Florida. Come on, people.
Yes, God. Thank you, Jesus.
It don't take, my God Almighty, no little hanky-panky thing. I tell you all, people of God, I said, one day you all will hear my story and then you all will understand. All you people hear me? Blazing and going through is because I try to prove my ability with God for Him to use me. You all don't get it. You all don't get it. I could have given up many years ago with this empowerment line, but I decide to push and pursue.
Persevere. Yes, yes.
Perseverance, my God Almighty, because the race is not for the switch.
Oh, no, it's not.
The race is not for those that be quick.
Oh, yes.
But it's for those that can do what? Endure it.
Yes.
It is not for the quick, but it's for those that can endure it.
Yes.
With the one that will do the shift. Come on, people, I love that. The race, write this down. The race is not for the quick.
Yes.
But it's for those that can endure it.
Yes.
You have to endure it. And enduring it, you better, my God Almighty, have a made up mind. Stop playing church.
Yes.
Stop the pretending. And stop the pity party thing. Get a book for those that are struggling and going through. And my God Almighty can't understand why thing is happening. Get a book. Write down, my God Almighty, all the bad ways that you can write down that you know you used to have or still operated in. Write it down. All the dirty, stinking ways that you know you used to have or still having some of them. And write them down. View your books as you write it. Look through it. And say, I don't need this. This is not right. This is not good. This is not right. This is not good. And call up to the Lord Jesus Christ and said, into my heart. Come into my heart, Lord Jesus. Come in to stay. Come in, I pray. Come into my heart, Lord Jesus. Because I rise up to tell you, whatever you are going through, whatever you are facing, if you don't pass that test, you cannot be with Him. Who am I talking? The King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. You have to pass your test. People of God, let me tell you all something. God made it to be very hard for me. Very hard. I have bear some hardship. You see Apostle Paul that we read about?
Yes.
My life line up with Apostle Paul so much.
Yes.
My life line up with him a lot. A lot when I read him, my life line up a lot with him.
Yes.
When the books.
Yes.
When the books. And everything that I have to do come forth, you all will understand it.
Amen.
When you read the books and hear the many things that I have been through, and I'm talking about people of God, God has given me the memory of ability to remember from I was 3 years of age. So the books are going to be very powerful. The books are going to be very powerful.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah.
I can remember going through from those days with my mother from 3 years of age. Three! Isn't that a blessing? When I look at my mommy and tell her things from I was a little baby girl like that, my mother said, oh my God. I tell my mother things that I used to see she and my aunties them do when they used to stand up and speak gypsy. And I'm standing up there looking in their face, hearing what they said. And I said, mommy, I remember you used to do these things, and I was trying to understand what you're all there talking. She said, oh my God. Come on, people. Oh my God. She shocked to hear these things. How many people you think can remember from they were so small? That is the reason why God gave me the ability. I can, my God Almighty, tap into your life from you were in your belly, your mother belly, and tell you what was going on until you come out. That is the reason why God give me that ability. And I rise up to tell you all, let me say this to you all. Until, from now until I move from this place, you don't see anything yet. Wait until when I move, you're going to see more, better. I promise you all that. I promise you all that, people of God. I promise you all that by the grace of God that you're going to see better. By His grace. By the grace of God, you're going to see all better. The best of Him is going to come out of me. The best of the Lord Jesus Christ is going to come out of me. The best of Jesus Christ. You know why? Because I have a made of mine.
That's right. Determination.
Have a made of mine. Because I have a made of mine, I'm not into no easy man schism, no Dalio's thing. I am not playing, I am doing. By the grace of God, I am doing. I am not playing. So people of God, let us get this serious in our spirit. Let us get this very serious in our spirit.
Amen.
If you have a made up mind, or if your mind don't made up, this message must help you to make up your mind. For you to get serious with the Lord Jesus Christ. This is no anky panky thing. Get out of the plane and come in the doings.
Amen.
Get out of the plane and come in the doings. Dolly House must be over. Burn that Dolly House down with fire.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Dolly house must be over. Burn that dolly house down with fire. Get in the doings with God. Dolly house is for Satan. Come on, people. Lift up Jesus Christ.
I want to see my Jesus someday. I got my mind made up, and I won't turn back, 'cause I want to see my Jesus someday. Come on, everybody say it.
To go God's way the rest of my life. Goodbye world, I stay no longer with you. Goodbye pleasures of sin, I stay no longer with you. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. When you're born, hey, hallelujah. When you're born again, you have Jesus within. Spirit and the blood, out of the spiritual womb.
Lifting up their hands,
yeah.
They bowed their heads. And
if there's anyone, my God Almighty, that want to say something, let them do it.
When we receive a word,
this word has bring
our answer should
seriousness
be,
or whatever
amen.
To them, let them do it.
Let the church say amen.
Exactly. People of God, if there's anybody gathered today that has been really impacted and touched by this word, something that you want to say as a result of hearing this powerful teaching, this powerful revelation of God, please come forth, state your name, and explain what the Lord did for you in hearing this message. Give you the chance. Go forth in Jesus' name. Anyone?
Please do not come and preach. Just take a minute to do it.
Just take a minute to talk about the message.
Hi, this is Jewel. I just thank God for the word that came forth out of the apostle today, and knowing that it's going to transform my life and the lives of people if we just grab hold of what she just said. I thank God even the change in my life that I've seen since I've been coming on the empowerment line and just playing the YouTube and I just see a change for the better. I just want to encourage her and thank God for her.
Bless God. Thank you, Sister Jewel. And, you know, this is the kind of testimony that really does help others when they hear it, when the message does go up on YouTube and people listen and they understand the difference that it has made in their life. It is such a source of encouragement, people. I don't even know how to stress that enough. But I bless God for Sister Jewel bringing forth that word. In Jesus' name, God bless you. Anyone else that would like to comment on today's teaching? Very, very powerful, very deep. Yes, Mother Ivana.
Mother Ivana, I'm looking God. Thanks, praise God, Anna. I thank God for this woman of God. And these are that message today. I remember answering one at a time. I dozed off when I answered. I was paying attention one at a time. And you know, from I. But she said, no. She answered the phone and I wasn't paying attention. But she spoke from there on, this conviction in my spirit. I know God is speaking to me. And I thank God because I really and truly, as soon as I pass the police message out, I'm going to really go right back into it and listen to everything it said. Because a lot was said in the conviction of my spirit. And I just thank God. I'm coming forth with this message the way he brought it today. In the name of Jesus, it is God. Glory be to God. And I have to really take heed in the name of Jesus. And I repent. I repent in Jesus' name. But some of the things that I'm not really doing, but I've tried my best, but I repent. And God see, I know my heart, and he knows what this woman of God has taught God. I thank God to say like this. The way he speaks to my spirit. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus.
Glory be to God. Thank you, Mother Yvonne. Anyone else that would like to come forth quickly? Want to give someone a chance before we move on?
Bless God. This is Sister Shalon.
Bless God. Go forth, my sister.
I just want to give God thanks for the message that was brought forth today. Especially about, you know, just in the areas where if there's like any strongholds or any presumptuous sin, you know, it's time to really like just look to God and to cry out unto God if there's anything going on. Because I remember there was time when the apostle, the Holy Spirit brought forth through her, you know, saying like if you continue like to just hold out, or like if you continue to be doing presumptuous sin, it's like, you know, you're not ready for God. So I'm just asking God to help me in those areas. God, he knows those areas of my life, and, you know, just to have me a heart, give me a heart that's ready to, you know, be committed to him, and to be ready to just hold on to, you know, to him and his word, because he's a God who is a deliverer. So just thank God for the message was brought forth. Today's message was really convicting. Just give God thanks for, you know, the message that came forth again. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God.
Glory to your name, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Is there anyone else? Anyone else? Well, I'm not going to labor, but I do want to say a couple of key things that really, really, really grabbed my attention was, what do you come to God for? To be saved or to get what you can get? And I thought that was so powerful because, you know, the woman of God said the race is, you know, is up to us. It's up to us to endure. It's up to us to stop pretending, have that made up mind. And I believe the powerful words at the end were, Dolly House must be over, burn it down with fire. And I'm telling you, I wrote that in big letters because that is such a powerful revelation. We are no longer children, but, you know, we are to grow and to mature and to, you know, move in him. And he wants us to stop the pretending. So I think that was so powerful. And a big message was get rid of the old and bring in the new. Because we are, as children of God, we are in new beginnings. We have 11 days left, as the woman of God reminded us, till we get to the 31st of this month. So Let us all take what we have heard and really apply it. I know I am myself. I'm speaking. When I speak, I'm speaking for myself as well, believe me. And, you know, those areas that are lagging, that are dragging, it's that push. It's that push. And I thank God for the level of energy that he's given the woman of God. She just has such a thrust. And that energy and that thrust makes me want to push more and encourages me to want to go higher and to do more for him. Because it's really not about us when it comes to, you know, winning souls. It's about them. It's about letting our light shine. So I thank God for today's message. I want to make sure if there's anybody else that has anything final to say before I make a few announcements for everyone. Please go forth right now in Jesus' name.
This is Minister Gay.
Yes.
Mother Shadow, the Mother Shadow is still on the land. She can't get on, so she has to say something.
Hold on. Let me see.
From the ear, trying to talk to speak. Until I come back online.
Okay, yeah, first. Mother Shirley, go forth.
Go forth, Mother Shirley.
Mother Shirley, I was to mute you out because your phone is beeping a lot.
During the recording.
I'm very sorry about that, so go forth now.
Go forth. Are you on, Mother Shirley?
Yes, God. I just want to give God thanks for today's message. Just really touched my inner core, you know, because and it said when, especially when Apostle Sharon was quoting the songwriter into my heart, and I'm just asking God, yes, just enter my heart and let me accept, because I know that sometimes it's just when she was quoting, like how people would say, God knows it, he knows my, you know, my heart, even if you're doing something wrong and you just want to say God knows and he's gonna excuse what you're doing because he knows you, you know, and he's like, I'm, you know, a child of God. He's gonna accept what I'm doing. So I'm just giving God thanks for this message today because it's true. God, no matter what we're doing, God knows, he knows each and every one of us, but it doesn't mean that, yes, he sees that what we're doing and we try, and I'm trying to live a Christian life or a righteous life for him, but he don't have to accept everything that I'm doing just because I say God knows me. So, you know, that it's okay for me to do things that's not pleasing and say God knows me. So I'm just giving God thanks and praises for the message that the woman of God came through with today, and it really, really touches, you know, everything that by the way of living, just to know how to live the righteous way and to know that, you know, you can't just think that God sees and gonna accept, because he doesn't have to accept me. I mean, he can say I can forgive, and to know that we should repent and repent daily. And I ask God just to keep me in mind to remind me to repent from anything that I'm doing that I don't think is wrong, that I can think it's right, but it's not me doing this right. I'm just giving God thanks and to the songwriter, you know, to enter my heart. I'm just asking him to, yes, enter my heart. And know, he knows our heart. He knows our mind. I already know our thoughts. I'm just asking that song just really touched me to enter my heart. Just stay in, you know, stay in your Jesus, stay in my heart.
Thank you, Lord. Bless God. Thank you, Mother Shirley. And, you know, I think the thing that we're hearing, people of God, the key we're hearing is accountability. You know, that's such a key thing. We have to take accountability. Because each one of us has to work out our own salvation with fear and trembling, like the Word says. We have to be accountable for our actions, for our thoughts. And you know, God is so gracious. He's getting us in that position. He wants us to be in that position because he wants to do so much for us and wants the blockages to go away because he wants us to experience that abundant life that he paid for so dearly at the cross. So I thank God for the boldness, for the honesty, for what the Holy Spirit did today. We have to give him praise, honor, and glory in Jesus' name. And for each and every one of you in the midst, how blessed we are to have this revelation and this teaching that the Holy Ghost is so gracious, so kind, to teach us, to instruct us, to guide us, to comfort us. Thank you, Lord. And I want each and every person to know that as we are going through this new season in Him, God is doing some different things right now. So if you do dial in and the line is not available, just try back the very next day. So continue to check it. And also you have the YouTube channel available to you 24/7. So you can certainly hook it up in your home. You can put it on your desktop, on your laptop. If you have a smartphone, you can take it with you wherever you go. You can hook up a very inexpensive cable in your car from your smartphone to the audio jack, and you can listen right through the speakers of your car. You can listen to the YouTube channel, and you can continue to be encouraged and be empowered to be blessed. And as the angels that are in operation with Apostle Sharon, that the angels that have been assigned to her life keep saying that prayer, angels, work for me like you work for Apostle. We are blessed for that powerful teaching and the dispatching of angels that we received during the teaching during the month of completion in July. So much He's done in these last 30 days. It's amazing. The acceleration of what He's doing in the Spirit is just, I'm so grateful. Grateful to God for each and every one of us to be privileged to take part and to hear and to have our lives changed. Remember to share the channel with others, family, relatives, neighbors, whomever the Lord puts on your heart, share it and continue putting your great testimonies and your comments and your likes on the YouTube channel. It is so helpful to others to hear because they get encouraged. They too will get empowered and strengthened because people are going through lots of situations. As I respond to them, just know that there are people around the world that are commenting on how their lives are being changed. There are messages coming from as far as Africa, all over Europe, Latin America, all different states in the United States, the Caribbean islands, everywhere. It is not just local, but we're hearing from people all over the world. And if any of you would like to bless this ministry, you can certainly do so by contacting me via the email helpforrepentanceservejesus@gmail.com. If the Lord puts it on your heart to bless the ministry monthly, whatever you pray about, you can reach me. I will correspond with you as to what to do. And I also encourage each and every one of you to continue to pray for this ministry. There are needs, you know, that the Lord knows, and we covet your prayers. We thank you for your prayers. And continue to pray for the woman of God as she's making this transition to Florida. The Lord has told her, has commissioned her as to what she's to do, as she's to take Florida. So we bless God and the world because these messages are going to the four corners of the earth. She has a heart for the nations, and know that she's a root digger. And when she prays, she will get to the root through the power and the help of the Holy Ghost and the angels that work alongside of her. So just continue to lift her up in your prayers. And as we close out this service, let us go forth and close it out. Mother Yvonne, if you could read Matthew 6, verses 9 through 15, let us all repeat after her in the mighty name of Jesus. Go forth, Mother Yvonne.
People of God, please repeat Matthew 6, verse 9 through 15 after me, boldly, please. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Our Father,
which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven.
Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread.
Give us this day our daily bread.
And forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors.
and forgive us
our debts as we forgive our debtors.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory.
Forever and ever, amen.
Forever
and ever, amen.
For if ye forgive men their trespasses,
for if ye forgive
men their
trespasses,
your heavenly Father will also forgive you.
Your heavenly Father will also forgive you.
But if ye forgive not men their trespasses,
but if ye forgive not men
their trespasses,
neither will your Father forgive your trespasses.
Neither
will your Father forgive your trespasses.
Glory be to God, hallelujah, amen.
Glory be to God,
hallelujah, amen.
Glory be to God, hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah.
Amen.
One other thing I wanted to say before we also close and let Apostle give the closing prayer. For anyone that you speak to about, this is not a prayer line, but this is an empowerment church that happens to meet online. So those of you know it, but just so that it goes up on the message for YouTube. Very important, because when we get together, we are a church, this is a body, and we come together to lift up the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Bless you all. Love you all in Jesus' holy name.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah. We bless the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We glorify and we thank him. And we honor him for his goodness and his mercy. People of God, just want for you all to be blessed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My God Almighty, and I just want you all to know that my God Almighty, Friday, my God Almighty service is already up. My God Almighty, I was able to put up three, my God Almighty message this morning from earlier, maybe about from 2 o'clock or... 2 o'clock this morning until, this morning out daylight. So, they're all up, people of God. So go and enjoy them in the name of Jesus Christ as we speak about this today, the date of the 20th, 2017. May you all be blessed. May the Lord Jesus Christ bless and keep you. May his face continue to shine upon you and your family. And don't forget, people of God, continue to call my God every morning, 6 o'clock, from Monday to Friday, and you will, and to know if I'm on or not, even on Sunday and 12 o'clock. God bless you all, you and your family, while my little granddaughter, DJ Naya, sing along with Don, and sing along with Nanny McCurkin, with Joshua, in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. There's no God like Jehovah. Be blessed in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. I receive it in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Glory.
Glory be to God. Thank you, Lord.
Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. No God like Jehovah.
There's no God like my Jesus. There's no God like my Jesus. There's no God like
God bless you. I love you all in Jesus' name.
Yes, receive it.
Love you, love you, love you. God bless you in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Under the bush in there. So what I'm saying, people of God, as children of the Most High God, you see, the reason why the Holy Ghost have me to teach such a powerful message pertaining to us here that is calling upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ is to show that many times we are struggling as even a newcomer, or as you know, funny life is, people of God, as a newcomer, somebody that just start to serve the Lord Jesus Christ and want to serve him and don't know much about him and don't understand what he's about, name it and what of you, and people of God, get what I'm saying.
Yes.
It takes ability to learn so much about God. What is ability? Ability is, my God Almighty, the effort that you are going to push out. Come on, people.
Yes.
Ability is, my God Almighty, you whatever you are doing, you must mean it. Come on, people. I feel the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Ability is what, people of God, when you make up your mind, you have to have a made up mind.
Yes.
Ability is when, my God Almighty, you're going to tell yourself, I'm finished with that and I'm ready for this. What is this? The things of God. Come on, people. And that is the sin. Come on, people.
Right.
You know why that is sin? Listen to this revelation. You know why that is sin? Notice when my God Almighty bleach, my God Almighty, at that half beach, bleach touch your clothes, or it destroy it. Bleach, my God Almighty. Notice, my God Almighty, if a woman having her menses and she sit down and didn't know when it was coming and it happened to go on the clothes, look how terribly it look, people of God, and even bring shame to that woman. Because that is what we don't want. When you finish with that, let it go back to who it belonged to, that wicked old Satan, that Lucifer. Come on, give God glory.
Hey, God, yes, Lord, thank you, Holy Spirit.
Come on, people. It takes a makeup mind. It rubble, people of God, this is powerful. I'm telling you, the Holy Spirit of me, my God Almighty. Roko satara kandar boshende.
Mighty God, hallelujah.
When my God Almighty, when people of God, if we really and truly want to get in the things of God, I don't know about nobody, but I tell some of you, people of God, that when I start out with the Lord Jesus Christ, I wasn't playing, and today I am not playing. Many Christians start out playing and still playing. That is the reason why I don't speak and said you need to play your part. No. Playing is playing. Doing is doing. Come on, people.
Hey. Yes.
Many things the Holy Spirit of God have me to be careful how I talk. Many things he wants, if I'm telling his people things, I must tell him what he is saying, not what I am thinking and doing. Come on, people. Not what the flesh wants.
Yes.
You don't play your part with God. You do your part with, like, oh, God do, you do. Come on, people. Why you think people, look at human being, what they say, monkey do. Come on, people.
Monkey say, monkey do.
If monkey can say and monkey can do, what about us with God? Come on, people. We are to say what God is saying and do what God is doing. Come on, people.
Amen.
Come on, people.
Yes.
A child of the Most High God that come to the Lord Jesus Christ, it don't, especially these last days, I can tell you something, people of God, there's a power that come in the midst. It is like, my God Almighty, sponge. It lap up and it sop up, and that's the power God want us our midst.
Mighty God, hallelujah. Jesus.
That's the type of power God wants for us to gain in the midst, people.
Thank you, Lord.
People of God, we are dealing with new beginning. Come on, people.
Amen.
Get rid of the whole and bring in the new. Write that down, Minister Gay. Get rid of the whole and bring in the new.
Yes.
New beginning. For you to get rid of the old and bring in the new as a child of God. As a child of God.
Amen.
Yes, amen.
People of God, let me say this to you all. That is the reason why these last days, those that are very serious for the Lord Jesus Christ, it don't take no, my God Almighty, it don't have to take you, no, my God Almighty, long time for you to start working for God. Come on, talk to me.
That's right. Yes, that's right.
If you have the ability, if you have the made up mind and have the ability, the ability is like, my God Almighty, a person that go to college and get their what? They get their what? What you get from your what?
Degree.
You get your degree. Go to high school, you get your diploma. Go to college, you get your degree. Come on, people.
Amen. Yes.
Did you know that on earth here, you have children, my God Almighty? They are so educated. What you call it? They come on, people. You educators, help me. There's a thing about like my life. Sister Merlin was here, she would just tap in, bop like that. Like Sister Merlin have a little grandbaby. That little baby IQ. Come on, people. She have a very IQ. Come on, talk to me.
High IQ.
Thank you. The baby have a high IQ. She don't when she talking, she don't talk like a 2-year old. She talk like a 6. People have got a child talk so big.
Yeah,
intelligent. She learned the computer. When Sister Merlin them try to give her a baby phone, she said no. She know the baby phone different from the adult phone. Come on, talk to me. She said, no, she don't want the baby phone. And people of God don't care what you're doing, she's not taking it. And she learned the phone on her very own.
My God.
That's how that little baby girl is. She go, and when she going in, she going for a little baby game, them a little A, B, C, D, da, 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 name it. She tap in, she know how to go in and get those things. You cannot fool that little 2 to 3 year old baby, you cannot. Collier, you cannot fool Collier. And there are many babies. You ever notice, my God Almighty, many children, my God Almighty, they have them on the television. If you should tap in, my God Almighty, on YouTube, you would see them, my God Almighty, doing many things. Come on, people. Children, my God Almighty, spelling as small as they is. They talk, they can tell you how many prime minister from the day one till now. They can tell you the president. They can tell you the name. They can call countries. They can do this, they can do that. If it's so with the natural, what do you think about the spiritual?
Hey.
Yes.
Don't you think the spiritual is more powerful? Come on, people.
Yes, it is.
Don't you think no, look at somebody like myself here. My God Almighty, I didn't able to gain education. What am I doing talking to all you that are educators? What am I doing? It's because, my God Almighty, I make up my mind to have that ability to do the will of God. Come on, people.
That's right. Perseverance. Yes, perseverance.
Perseverance. Come on, people.
Amen.
It takes perseverance. Many people said they love the Lord God Almighty. But still yet, as your queen, my God Almighty, they turn away from him. And they're going to do something that is called S-I-N, sin. Come on, people.
Right.
To really love him, you will please him. Come on, talk to me. You will
keep his
commandment. Yeah. You will keep his commandment. Come on, people.
Yeah.
What I'm trying to say,
amen.
If a little baby, my God Almighty, can able to have a high IQ, why can't you have, my God Almighty, a deepness to want to do for the Lord Jesus Christ? Come on, talk to me.
Hallelujah. Yes. Mighty God, Jesus.
It is available. It is available for every single person.
Thank you, Lord God.
You might not, my God Almighty, have a calling upon your life to be, my God Almighty, all the five, my God Almighty, hallelujah. What was said? Pastors, teachers, prophet, the fivefold ministry. You might not have it on you to be a deacon, a minister, hold on, Jesus. Jesus.
Conference unmuted.
I'm back. The conference was muted. You might not, my God Almighty, be a deacon, a minister, name it whatever, but you might just be what? Somebody that go into church. Let me say this to you all. You have church goers and you have children of God. Come on, talk to me.
Right.
Many people don't believe that. Many people believe that because they see church full and everybody come to church, everybody is safe. Yep. But the only thing can prove that, to show that many don't save, just let the trumpet blow and then you will see who and who was saved.
That's right. That's so true.
Just let the trumpet blow. Then you will know who and who was saved. Let me say this to you, to us all here, people of God. Let us not miss it either in death or in resurrection. Let us not miss it.
Amen.
Let us not miss it.
God.
Let us not miss it.
Jesus, not to miss it.
Let us not miss it. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes, Holy Spirit.
Let us not miss it. People of God, we have, my God, we can, my God Almighty, do things to please God. Stop. We can do things to please God and stop grieving God. Stop grieving God. He wants to do so much for you and I, but because we keep grieving Him, the Holy Spirit that He have here in earth cannot come in and operate for us. It is the Holy, listen to me, for us here on earth, it is the Holy Spirit that make the way. Come on, people.
Amen.
The angel, let me tell you something, people of God. The very angel that my God Almighty here are calling upon, angel that here many people calling upon, angel that God Himself has created, they cannot operate without the Holy Spirit. Cannot.
Right.
God, listen to me. God Himself could not operate without the Holy Spirit. Come on, talk to me.
Amen.
Because He created the Holy Spirit as a human in spirit to work for Him, because He will not come down here on earth as God. Come on, talk to me. And do it.
Amen.
He will not.
He will.
The angel depends on the Holy Spirit. Come on, people.
Yes.
Because it is so plain for us to see when Jesus said, when I go up, I will send the Comforter.
Comforter.
Without, if we don't have the Holy Spirit in the midst, people of God, what happened to many of us? We are miserable. And the Holy Spirit cannot work without righteousness and holiness. Cannot.
Right.
You want to see God work for you? Make up in your mind to get rid of the foolishness.
Yes.
Get rid of the bickering, the complaining, the this and the that. Name it, people of God. You don't need that. You need to come and do for the Lord Jesus. That's what we need, people. You have my God Almighty in the midst. If you look, my God Almighty, if some of you should go on YouTube, which I believe you do, you would even see some little children preaching. Come on, talk to me.
It's true. Yes.
You would see some little children do. I saw a little baby boy. This little boy could not be more than maybe 5. He end up die. And I know for sure that child didn't have to die, but because More or less, he probably didn't have somebody in the midst to pray him through and help him through. But God used him in a way before he died, the little boy. It was sent to the phone. I think it was sometime last year I read it. And this little baby boy was talking. He's talking and said how much he loved Jesus, and he know that when he die, he's going to the Lord Jesus, and he's going. And his conversation was like a blowing mind conversation. It was a mind blowing. Thank you. It was a mind blowing, people of God, when he was speaking. And I'm looking at it to say, if a little baby child like that can speak that way, what about us as grown people? Come on, people. What about us? Keep grieving the heart of God. Keep doing things that is not pleasing in the sight of God. God don't want for us to keep doing these things. Come on, people. It is not for us to keep doing these things. We have to have a made up mind. Because I rise up to tell you, when I was in sin, I can talk about myself. When I was in sin and was out there, and know that I come in, it is far way different. To me, it is the best. I don't know about any other. I don't see any life that is, people of God, can somebody find sweetness in life when there is suffering and struggling going on? Yes, you can. What you talking about now? You can find it, because as long as you have Jesus Christ in the midst, as long as the Holy Spirit is in the midst, there is nothing sweeter than that.
Amen.
How you think, my God Almighty, I able to pray all these prayers? How you think I able to do all these things and going through all kind of suffering? How you think I do it? You think I just do it because, my God Almighty, oh, this, that, and the other? No. It's because, people of God, I made up my mind. You have to have a made up mind for the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Some people come to the Lord Jesus Christ because they want to do what? Prostitute him.
Yes.
What am I talking about? What am I talking about when I said because they want to prostitute him? They want to play game. They think their little mind can, my God Almighty, fool him. They think that he don't know about their mind. Because you see, some people claim that is their mother create them, is not God. That's the only set of people that's supposed to think like that. But if we know that we were created by God, we are not to think like that as if our little mind can fool God. No.
That's right.
Leave that to the ignorant. Leave that to those that, my God Almighty, their children grow up because their parents tell them that there is no God. Leave that to them.
That's right.
Let us, my God Almighty, prove to them and show them that there is a God. By whatever God to do in our life, when God do it in our life, then the gates of hell cannot prevail over us. Come on, people.
Yes, amen, hallelujah.
The gates of hell cannot prevail. We have the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, as my God Almighty, a child of the Most High God. You don't even need, the Bible tells us, people of God, that somebody find it. Having the Holy Spirit, my God Almighty, you don't even need nobody, because he will teach you all things. Come on, talk to me. If you really and truly make up your mind, he will teach you all things. He will teach you all things. Come on, people.
Amen.
He will teach you all things, people.
Amen. Yes.
If you only open up, my God Almighty, for him to teach you. Cry out for whatever, my God Almighty. Almighty, you believe, you know it's a blockage. Because from the moment you welcome in, you must have that, my God Almighty, sense of humor to know that you're operating the same way you used to. And that is the reason why he can't able to come in. Come on, people.
Amen.
Look at some people. Many people see me. You all remember the lady, the young miss that right on the line. Apostle, can you pray for me so that I pray I be like you? The young miss said, can you pray for me so that I can be like you? Some people will ask God for some kind of things. But when God started to move in for them to get it, they start to cry out and say, the devil is doing this and this is happening and that is happening and da da da. You see, sometimes it's not the devil. Sometimes it's a test you're taking. Come on, talk to me.
Hey, that's right. Yeah.
I said sometimes it's not the devil. Sometimes it's a test you're taking. Bless God. 1 John 2:27. Go ahead and read it. Read it.
But you have received the Holy Spirit, and he lives within you. So you don't need anyone to teach you what is true. For the Spirit teaches you everything you need to know. And what he teaches is true. It is not a lie. So just as he has taught you, remain in fellowship with Christ.
You hear that? You have to get rid of the hanky panky. You have to get rid of sin. Get rid of what has been a blockage in your life all the time before you come to the Lord Jesus Christ. You cannot be walking on the same road. You have to get off the busy road and get on the lonely road.
Amen.
You have to. Friends you used to have, you will realize that you don't have them anymore. That's a change. Things you see you used to do, you will realize that you don't do it no more. That's a change. The way you used to talk, you will find you're not talking like that. That's a change.
Amen.
Name it. But if you see yourself doing the same thing, I rise up to tell you, Jesus don't enter in as yet.
Come on now.
I said, if you see yourself still cursing bad word, if you see yourself still, my God Almighty, fighting, carrying on, using the same all, doing the same all, name it and one of you, Jesus don't enter yet. When you open up your mouth to say you're my God Almighty doing the confession prior, you were only fooling yourself. It is a lip thing. It's not coming from the heart. It's not coming from the heart. You have to persevere and say, my God Almighty, enough is enough and I don't want this kind of life. Because I rise up to tell you, when you speak against Satan, he have to take away his little filthy self. But when you speak the things that he speak, he will continue living with you.
Amen.
When you continue speaking what Satan speak. But when you don't, my God Almighty, you see, when I just got saved, let me say something to you all. When I just got saved, I never forget when I give my Lord myself to the Lord Jesus Christ. Two things was a stronghold on my life: sex and bad words. Dirty language, dirty talking, name it and whatever. Those were stronghold upon my life. And what you all need to get and understand, I never forget, after knowing that I got saved in the house, I go to the church and I got baptized. I was my God Almighty one day. Then you see, when it happened, you know, people of God, and this is how it go, you know. The Lord will allow things to happen in the midst of people. And you will even prove to this, to whoever it happened in the midst of, to see how much they are with you or not. Come on, talk to me.
Amen.
And it happened, my God Almighty, that I was right there, sitting down one day in the yard, at the front of my yard. And a young miss came that, you know, I happened to meet her at the church that I start to go to. And never know that the Lord want me to go to that church just to get baptized. Come on, people, talk to me. I said he wanted for me just to go to the church to get baptized. So I went to the church, got baptized, met with the young miss, came back. Day passed, weeks passed, name it. One day I was sitting down. And while I was there sitting down, I believe I was talking on the phone or something. And something just irritate my spirit. And the same way I curse the bad word, they just come out like brrr. I say, oh my God, Jesus, Jesus. People of God, what if you hear what I'm saying? When the bad word come out of my mouth, I did not stay quiet. I said, oh my God, Jesus, 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 have mercy, Jesus. Come on, people. Why? Because I have the ability to push forward.
Yes,
yes, yes, yes, yes. Those that don't have the ability to push forward, if they curse bad words, if they do whatever, they don't, my God, it doesn't matter to them. It is like nothing to them. Come on, talk to me. If you find yourself doing that, it's sure that Jesus is not on the inside of you yet.
That's right. Yes, be puzzled.
He's not. Because I rise up to tell you, when Jesus come in, nobody can push him out unless you do it. Only you. The devil cannot push him out. Only you.
Yeah.
I catch myself. And I started to, people of God, in a quick and a second, right before the young miss, I was like, sorry, my sister, sorry, sister, sorry, sister. And I was there praying. I said, oh, Jesus, have mercy, Jesus, forgive me. People of God, from that day until today, I don't curse bad word again. From 2003, come on, people, in the summer, June. I hear June 11th, Lord God Almighty. Hallelujah!
Glory!
2003, June 11th. Come on, people.
Yeah.
I don't curse another bad word until today, and the devil not going to let me curse any.
Yeah.
Come on, people.
Yeah.
And what you all need to understand, I was an entertainer. I used to sing out there, going to club, going to dance, going to this, going to that. I know it all. Come on, people.
Yeah.
I used to be out there, but none of those always follow me. Why? Because I have a made up mind. Some people come to God to get what they can get. Some people come to God because they want to be saved. Come on, people.
Right.
I wonder if you all get that one a while ago. Some people come to God to be saved. Some come to get what they can get. Write that one down.
Yes.
Come on, people. What do you come to God for? To be saved or to get what you can get? Come on. What do you come to God for? Are you sick and tired of being in sin? Or you just want to play a little party with him? No, I'm sorry. He will not come to your party. You cannot give him an invitation. He don't take those kind of invitation. Jesus Christ do not take those kind of invitation. The Holy Spirit do not take those kind of invitation. When you're writing an invitation to him, you have to write, goodbye world, I'm no longer with you. Goodbye sin, I'm no longer with you. I made up my mind to go God's way all of the time. Come on, people.
Amen.
Those are the invitation he takes. I wonder if you all hear what I'm saying. And the only way you can give God such an invitation, you have to what? Have a made up mind. He see the heart. We cannot hide from God. If you want to do the same thing over and over and over, that is called what? Presumptuous. Come on, talk to me. Many, my God Almighty, I said, you have people that will make mistakes, and you have people that have a presumptuous behavior. One of you all hear what I'm saying, people? And God knows the difference. He knows when you made up your mind, and he knows when you have a presumptuous behavior. We cannot hide from God. None of us can hide from him. He is God. He is God and God alone. Come on, people. That's why he alone sits on the throne. He is God and God alone. That's why he alone sits on the throne. We cannot play with him. We cannot play with him. I tell people this. If you are serving God, serve him. If you want to please the devil, go and stay with the devil. But don't think we have to understand we cannot play hanky panky party. Come on, talk to me. It's not about no hanky panky party. God don't play. God is not a God that play. He do. Come on, people. He do. And in his doing, he's very true. Come on, people. God, talk to me. In his doings, he's very true.
Yes, amen.
He don't play game. We cannot play game with him. He don't play. Many people today are playing church. God is not into the plain church. Yeah. When we were small children, we play room for rent, supply with me. When I run out, then you run in. Anyone on the line remember that game?
Yes, amen. Yes,
yes, yes.
And look into it. If we want to, my God Almighty, think that our little mind can deceive my God Almighty God when we are playing those kind of game. You think God don't know it?
Yes, he knows it.
Today we are, tomorrow we call. Today we are, tomorrow we call. Today you are, tomorrow. Come on, people. Room for rent, supply with me. Satan run in. Satan run out. Jesus run in. Room for rent, supply with me. Satan come in. Jesus come out. I rise up to tell you, he's not the kind of God that you can confuse. He don't play confused game.
No.
And I rise up to tell you, when a person that behave like this, Jesus is not in. It's just the Holy Spirit trying to come in the midst. But the Holy Spirit can't able. That is the reason why some people say, oh, I feel a little tingling. Oh, I feel a little pimples come upon my skin. That is for those that is playing. Come on, talk to me.
Amen.
When you can feel the rushing water moving on the inside, you know that Jesus is inside, even if you don't have the speaking of tongues. You will feel the living water bubbling up. Come on, people. Those that are playing with God only can feel the pimple, the little pimples and the little bubbling and the little brushing, and it's like a wind blowing on you. Oh, I feel a little chill. I feel a little this. I feel. You don't need that.
No good stuff.
You need, my God Almighty, to feel the power of God, my God Almighty, moving on the inside. Come on, people.
Amen.
Moving on the inside.
Yes.
That's even so. When you feel it, you might not, my God Almighty, feel tongues coming up. But if you start to feel tongues, it tongues start to push out like a rushing mighty wind. Okay. Come on, people. Being with the Lord Jesus Christ is no anky-panky plating. It best, my God Almighty, who want to stay with the devil, best they stay with the devil. Who want to be with Jesus, best you be with Jesus. Come on, people. You see, whenever I'm preaching, teaching, and talking, I don't play. I speak it just as how the Lord want me to bring it forth. Come on, people. This is a very serious walk with God. I said this is a very serious walk with God. This is no joke thing. It is not for us to play church. It is for us to get serious. Don't play church, do church. Come on, people. You don't need to play God, do God. Come on, people.
Amen.
Get out of the plane. Don't bother with the room for rent supply with me, because I rise up to tell you, when you run him out, he don't just force himself in. It don't happen like that. If you do the confession prior, and you have a made up, you see, that is the thing about it, people of God. And many people think that I am an apostle from the Most High God. That's a calling on my life. And this is a very heavy calling, and I don't play with sin.
Right, amen.
I do not play with sin. I'm very radical for my God.
Amen.
Very radical for him. If we are serving God, let us serve him. If you're not serving God, don't try to, my God Almighty. It's just like some people. You ever notice some people, my God Almighty, they are as broke as a church mouse. But when they see rich people, they hop into the company of rich people. They will take their, my God Almighty, mortgage. They will take their car note money. They will take everything, insurance money, everything. Buy the most bling bling. Buy the this. They will even go and pay them on a car that look big and rich, just to be in the company of rich people. And they are not rich. Come on, people.
Hey, this
that is how some people is with God.
In the park.
Want to play. Come on, people. Go into restaurant. You know when you go into the restaurant and order the food, my God Almighty, what you think happen? You know for sure that when you pay for the food, you're not going to have no money to pay to even, if you don't drive, you might have to walk. Come on, talk to me. I'm not saying that God can't have his people them to live good and can able to go into whatever restaurant, name it. I'm not talking about that, so nobody don't look at it like that. I'm talking about people that want to pretend as if they are when they are not.
That's it.
Playing the game. And don't know that it is going to have what brings shame. When you play the game, it brings shame. Come on, people. But when you do, my God Almighty, what is right, then you will have right beside you the Lord Jesus Christ. Give him glory. Playing game will bring you shame, but having the Lord Jesus Christ in the midst, you will have him in, my God Almighty, beside you, right at your side. He will present himself, my God Almighty, the Holy Spirit, and you will become friend. You see, people don't understand the Holy Spirit is, you hear what him, you hear what it here, it name? You hear what him name? The Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
You don't even need to put righteousness in the midst of your talking. Just say the Holy Spirit. Because when somebody lives in holy, righteousness causes it to become holy.
Amen.
Only righteousness. Only righteousness can have you to become holy. What is righteousness? Everything you are doing, you are being so careful because you don't want to grieve the Spirit of God. That is righteousness, people. When you're doing right, when you want to live a righteous life in the sight of the Lord Jesus Christ. Come on, people. That's the only way you can please God. You have to get on the road of righteousness before you start to say you are holy. Come on, people. You have to get to a place where you know for sure you know good and you know bad. Come on, people. You have to, my God Almighty, have, my God Almighty, something that is called a conscience on the inside. And whenever, my God Almighty, you commit wrong, that conscience be convicted. Come on, people.
Yes, amen.
If you are doing wrong and you're not, your conscience have not been convicted, right there, Jesus Christ is not on the inside. He's not. It's a vain imagination going on. Vain imagination. Come on, talk to me.
Amen.
That is what is called vain imagination. You are fooling yourself. Living for the Lord Jesus Christ is not no dally house. Get out of the dally house. We used to pretend. The people that play dally house are people that are pretend that they are mothers and they are fathers. Come on, talk to me. You pretend, my God Almighty. You even will take a real baby and pretend that you are the mother for that baby. As well as we used to use the little doll. Come on, people, use the little doll. And that's the baby. But you have the mother and you have the real mother and the real father. That's how it is. We are real, but the life that we are living is false. Come on, people. Everybody stuck? We have to, for us to get that new beginning. Come on, people. We cannot play church. No playing of church. And we don't need to, I don't care. God understand. God, that's another talking with some of us. Oh, yes, I know I did wrong, but God understand. Thank God that he's not like man. Leave me alone and da da da. And you start to curse and you start to carry on, putting more sin on sin. Somebody see you doing something. I said, oh, could you behave like that? And you said you're a child of God. Don't you say you get saved? Why are you talking like that? You're talking the same way you used to be out there. You're cursing bad words. You're doing this, you're doing that, da, da, da. Don't you stay? Why are you still doing all these things? Why you say, oh, you know, I need to pray. Oh God, pray for me. Don't pray for me. Help me, Jesus. When you behave like that, it shows that you're getting humble. Come on, talk to me.
Right.
You really and truly want to live for the Lord Jesus Christ. But you know the matter with some of us? Some of us believe that, my God Almighty, God loves us so much that he's going to stay with us in our mess. Some of us believe that God loves us so much that the things that we used to do, we must still do it. And then when we're ready, we can brush off. Like I said, when I used to be small, I used to, my God, love to steal out my mother's meat. I was a little kitchen rat.
Yeah.
I was a little kitchen rat. I wasn't the bedroom, I wasn't the living room, I wasn't nowhere else. I was just the kitchen rat. because I used to be very greedy and I always like to steal out food. And when I steal food out, people of God, and when you see I put that food, I don't know how I manage with this tongue. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, to know that you are God to help me. Because this tongue could have burned off already and come to nothing. Yes. I always teeth the food, and when my mother looking at throw it in my mouth, and people of God, I don't know how I swallow that hot food, and I will squeeze my eyes and my throat will be on fire, every part of me. It's the mercy of God that helped me. Because I was a little kid, and then I would just wipe off my mouth. And when my mother called, talk, I would, if the food going down, I would pretend, I know to pretend to, what's the matter with you? Oh, I try to swallow, maybe my speech go and lie beside it. And that's the thing about us. Some of us are lying to ourselves, say we're serving God. We are lying to ourselves, but we're not lying to God. We are not lying to God, people. We are lying to ourselves. We are pretenders. When some of us behind closed door, we do everything that we used to. But when we come out in the open of people, we pretend. We cannot hide from God. We cannot. Come on, people. The comforter see everything.
Man, yes.
The comforter report to the angel, and the angel report to God.
Yes.
Come on, people.
Yes. Oh, yes.
The comforter see everything. That is the reason why we can't see the comforter. We can only feel the comforter. The comforter see everything and report to the angel. And the angel slide on the ladder. You see when the angels them coming down, people of God? You see when they, when you hear, when you don't hear it, but you see when the angel, this is how angel move. And this that I'm doing is when they go up and come down in a, oh God Almighty, I tell you, in a shift. Come on, people, in a shift.
Yes.
Not no shift and no second.
A shift.
In a shift. Look at the hand. Look at the hand of the clock. The hand of the clock have to go on second.
Yeah.
It go on minute. It go on minute and it change to second. That is the reason why God timing is different from ours.
Amen.
Our time and his time is different. He move in a shift. By the time you, by all right, if God said, if all right, no, look at this. That is the reason. Can I teach a little something, people of God?
Yes.
That is the reason why with Elijah and Elisha, when both of them was here on earth in those days as prophet, and when Elisha found out that Elijah is going to cart up, what you think Elisha do? Elisha decide not to take his eyes from off him.
Right.
Come on, people.
Amen, yeah.
Because if he was to even take it, if people, can you imagine how he tried not to quint? Can you imagine the tension, my God Almighty, that Elisha have to go through just to see his father, Elijah, going up so that he can catch that mantle?
Yes.
It was a perseverance.
Yes.
It was an ability that he shows.
Yeah.
He made up his mind when the prophets them or whoever come around. Oh, Elijah, don't you know that your father is going to cart up? Oh, why don't you shut your mouth? I know it. You don't need to tell me. I know it. Why? Because, you see, because what? When he tell them to, you don't have to tell me, just ease off. He don't want them to do what distract him, because the time they're going to listen, he's going to stand up and listen to them and pay them attention. Elijah might just caught up and he miss it. Come on, people.
Amen. Yes.
So right there, he have to, my God Almighty, keep his eyes on him.
Yes.
I don't know if you all getting and understand what I'm talking about, people.
Amen. Yes.
He had was to keep his eyes on him.
Yes.
Because God move in a shift. Come on, people. God don't listen to me. God do not quick, and he do not, what is the next word I tell you all? God move in a shift. We are the one that are quick to do things, and the devil switch. Come on, people.
Okay.
The reason why Satan cannot quick is because he can only go to and fro. Come on, people. We as children of God, because we are so fleshy and we always believe that we know and with this and with that, we will be very quick to do things. That's why the Bible said be slow to speak and quick to hear. Quick belong to us. Come on, people.
Right.
Quick belong to us, and we can be quick to rebuke as well. You're quick to rebuke when you see you do something or you sin or you make a mistake. Yes, we can make mistakes because we are in the flesh and the devil can tempt us. Come on, people. But whenever you see you do something, be quick, my God Almighty, to do what? Rebuke it. Repent. Turn. God will do things in a shift. And when you see something done in a shift, people of God, you cannot change it. Come on, talk to me. It only takes God to change whatever shift he makes. Come on, people. Only God can change that shift.
Yes,
and when we are quick to do things, we can only repent about it, and God will change it in a shift. When God shift, he turn away the left and give us the right. Come on, people.
Amen.
He turn away the wrong and give us the right. Come on, people. God turn things. Come on, people. God turn things. That's why he shift. That is the reason why he shift, because he's a God on time. Come on, people, in whatever he's doing. He's an on time God. He's always on. Listen to me. Not in. Not to. Not far. He's an on. He's a always on time God. That means if you have him in the midst, he will stay on you. Come on, people. His eyes will stay on you.
Amen.
Because he's a on time God. Come on, people. He's a on time God. Get that in your midst. So, children of God, it is for us to do the things that is pleasing, my God Almighty, in his sight. Live for the Lord Jesus Christ. Live to please him. Stop pleasing man. Man will fail, but God will never fail.
Hallelujah.
Stop live to please people and please God. Stop grieving him. Come on, people. Stop grieving God.
Thank you, Jesus.
We are to stop grieve God. Stop grieving God. and please God. That's what we need to do. Stop grieving God and please God.
Yes, yes.
We are doing it too much. That is the reason why when we keep doing things over and over, what he said he will leave us to our reprobate mind. When God tells us that our mind are reprobate, it means we are acting like as if we are animals. Animals that have no sense. No sense. We have no sense, no conscience, no nothing. Nothing is operating us that is good. And when God's spirit have to leave us, that is too sad. If we are going through something, it don't mean that the spirit of God leave us. It means that he wants to take us on a level with him.
Hallelujah.
All we need to do is to say, Lord, help me to go through and to make it to the end, to complete this. Help me to go through and to complete. The reason why I can speak like this, people of God, I have been there.
Amen.
The amount of tests that I have to take to reach where I am, you all would not believe it. You wouldn't understand it. You would have to go through it. But I don't wish these things for you. Because people of God, just imagine serving the Lord Jesus Christ, going through all these things, so many years. Come on, people.
Yes.
I have served my time serving the Lord from 2003 until now. It's going, my God, it's what? How long is it? Can somebody help me? 14 years going to 15. Which one of them? Am I at 14 or 15?
14.
14 years and some months.
14 and yeah.
14 years and some months. Can you understand what that means, people of God? That is the reason why God is getting me ready to possess Florida. Come on, people.
Hey, thank you, Jesus. Go ahead.
He's getting ready for me to possess Florida. Come on, people.
Yes, God. Thank you, Jesus.
It don't take, my God Almighty, no little hanky-panky thing. I tell you all, people of God, I said, one day you all will hear my story and then you all will understand. All you people hear me blazing and going through is because I try to prove my ability with God for him to use me. You all don't get it.
Amen.
You all don't get it. I could have given up many years ago with this empowerment line, but I decide to push and pursue. Perseverance, my God Almighty, because the race is not for the switch.
Oh, no, it's not.
The race is not for those that be quick.
Oh, yes.
But it's for those that can do what? Endure it.
Yes.
It is not for the quick, but it's for those that can endure it. With the one that will do the shift. Come on, people, I love that. The race, write this down. The race is not for the quick. But it's for those that can endure it. You have to endure it. And enduring it, you better, my God Almighty, have a made up mind. Stop playing church.
Yes.
Stop the pretending. And stop the pity party thing. Get a book for those that are struggling and going through. And my God Almighty can't understand why thing is happening. Get a book. Write down, my God Almighty, all the bad ways that you can write down that you know you used to have or still operated in. Write it down. All the dirty, stinking ways that you know you used to have or still having some of them. and write them down. View your books as you write it. Look through it and said, I don't need this. This is not right. This is not good. This is not right. This is not good. And call up to the Lord Jesus Christ and said, into my heart. Come into my heart, Lord Jesus. Come in to stay. Come in, I pray. Come into my heart, Lord Jesus. Because I rise up to tell you, whatever you are going through, whatever you are facing, if you don't pass that test, you cannot be with him. Who am I talking? The King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. You have to pass your test. People of God, let me tell you all something. God made it to be very hard for me. Very hard. I have bear some hardship. You see Apostle Paul that we read about?
Yes.
My life line up with Apostle Paul so much.
Yes.
My life line up with him a lot. A lot when I read him, my life line up a lot with him.
Yes.
When the books and everything that I have to do come forth, you all will understand it.
Amen.
When you read the books and hear the many things that I have been through, and I'm talking about people of God, God has given me the memory of ability to remember from I was 3 years of age. So the books are going to be very powerful. The books are going to be very powerful.
Glory to God, hallelujah.
I can remember going through from those days with my mother from 3 years of age. Three! Isn't that a blessing? When I look at my mommy and tell her things from I was a little baby girl like that, my mother said, oh my God. I tell my mother things that I used to see she and my aunties them do when they used to stand up and speak gypsy. And I'm standing up there looking in their face, hearing what they said. And I said, mommy, I remember you used to do these things, and I was trying to understand what you all there talking. She said, oh my God. Come on, people. Oh my God. She shocked to hear these things. How many people you think can remember from they were so small? That is the reason why God gave me the ability. I can, my God Almighty, tap into your life from you were in your belly, your mother belly, and tell you what was going on until you come out. That is the reason why God give me that ability. And I rise up to tell you all, let me say this to you all. Until, from now until I move from this place, you don't see anything yet. Wait until when I move, you're going to see more, better. I promise you all that. I promise you all that, people of God. I promise you all that by the grace of God that you're going to see better. By His grace. By the grace of God, you're going to see all better. The best of Him is going to come out of me. The best of the Lord Jesus Christ is going to come out of me. The best of Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Lord God Almighty.
You know why? Because I have a made of mine.
That's right. Determination.
I have a made of mine. Because I have a made up mind, I'm not into no easy man schism, no Dalio's thing. I am not playing, I am doing. By the grace of God, I am doing, I am not playing. So people of God, let us get this serious in our spirit. Let us get this very serious in our spirit.
Amen.
If you have a made up mind, or if your mind don't made up, this message must help you to make up your mind.
Amen.
For you to get serious with the Lord Jesus Christ. This is no hanky panky thing. Get out of the plane and come in the doings.
Amen.
Get out of the plane and come in the doings. Dolly House must be over. Burn that Dolly House down with fire.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Dolly House must be over. Burn that Dolly House down with fire.
Amen.
Get in the doings with God. Dolly House is for Satan. Come on, people. Lift up Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
I want to see my Jesus someday. I got my mind made up, and I won't turn up, 'cause I want to see my Jesus someday. Come on, everybody say,
to go God's way the rest of my life. Goodbye world, I stay no longer with you. Goodbye pleasures of sin, I stay no longer with you. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. When you're born, hey, hallelujah. When you're born again, you have Jesus within. Spirit and the blood, out of the spiritual womb.
Up their hands,
yes.
They bowed their heads. And
if there's anyone, my God Almighty, that want to
say something, let them do it.
When we receive a word,
this word has bring
our answer should be
seriousness or whatever
amen.
To them, let them do it.
Let the church say amen.
Exactly. People of God, if there's anybody gathered today that has been really impacted and touched by this word, something that you want to say as a result of hearing this powerful teaching, this powerful revelation of God, please come forth, state your name, and explain what the Lord did for you in hearing this message. Give you the chance. Go forth in Jesus' name. Anyone?
Please do not come and preach. Just take a minute to do it.
Just take a minute to talk about the message.
Hey, this is Jewel. I just thank God for the word that came forth out of Apostle today. And knowing that it's going to transform my life and the lives of people if we just grab hold of what she just said. I thank God even for the change in my life that I've seen since I've been coming on the empowerment line and just playing the YouTube. And I just see a change for the better. So I just want to encourage her. Thank God for her.
Bless God. Thank you, Sister Jewel. And, you know, this is the kind of testimony that really does help others. When they hear it, when the message does go up on YouTube and people listen and they understand the difference that it has made in their life, it is such a source of encouragement, people. I don't even know how to stress that enough. But I bless God for Sister Jewel bringing forth that word. In Jesus' name, God bless you. Anyone else that would like to comment on today's teaching? Very, very powerful,
Mother
very
Ivana.
Deep. Yes, Mother Ivana.
Mother Ivana, I must give God thanks, praise, glory, and honor. I thank God for this woman of God. And these are that message today. I remember answering one of the time. I dozed off when I answered. I was paying attention one of the time. And you know, from I. But she said, no, she answered, I wasn't paying attention. But from there on, this conviction in my spirit, I know God is speaking to me. And I thank God because I really and truly, as soon as I pass the foot of this message out, I'm going to really go right back into it and listen to everything it said. Because a lot was said, and it's kind of an spirit. And I just thank God for coming forth with this message the way he brought it today. In the name of Jesus, it is God. Glory be to God. And I have to really take heed in the name of Jesus. And I repent. I repent in Jesus' name. But some of the things that I'm not really doing, but I've tried my best, but I repent. And God see, I know my heart, and he knows what this woman of God, I thank God to really say like this. The way he speaks to my spirit. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus.
Glory be to God. Thank you, Mother Yvonne. Anyone else that would like to come forth quickly? I want to give someone a chance before we move on.
Bless God. This is Sister Shalon.
Bless God. Go forth, my sister.
I just want to give God thanks for the message that was brought forth today, especially about, you know, just in the areas where there's like any struggles or any presumptuous sin, you know, it's time to really like just look to God and to cry out unto God if there's anything going on, because I remember there's time the apostle, the Holy Spirit brought forth to her, you know, saying like if you continue like to just hold on, or like if you continue to be doing presumptuous sin, it's like, you know, you're not ready for God. So I'm just asking God to help me in those areas. God, he knows those areas of my life, and you know, just to have me a heart, give me a heart that's ready to, you know, be committed to him, and to be ready to just hold on to, you know, to him and his word, because he's a God who is a deliverer. So just thank God for the message I brought forth. Today's message was really convicting. I give God thanks for, you know, the message that came forth again. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God.
Glory to your name, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Is there anyone else? Anyone else? I'm not going to labor, but I do want to say a couple of key things that really, really, really grabbed my attention was, what do you come to God for? To be saved or to get what you can get? And I thought that was so powerful because, you know, the woman of God said the race is, you know, is up to us. It's up to us to endure. It's up to us to stop pretending, have that made up mind. And I believe the powerful words at the end were, Dolly House must be over, burn it down with fire. And I'm telling you, I wrote that in big letters because that is such a powerful revelation. We are no longer children, but, you know, we are to grow and to mature and to, you know, move in him. And he wants us to stop the pretending. So I think that was so powerful. And a big message was get rid of the old and bring in the new. Because we are, as children of God, we are in new beginnings. We have 11 days left, as the woman of God reminded us, till we get to the 31st of this month. So let us all take what we have heard and really apply it. I know I am myself. I'm speaking. When I speak, I'm speaking for myself as well, believe me. And, you know, those areas that are lagging, that are dragging, it's that push. And I thank God for the level of energy that he's given the woman of God. She just has such a thrust. And that energy and that thrust makes me want to push more and encourages me to want to go higher and to do more for him. Because it's really not about us when it comes to, you know, winning souls. It's about them. It's about letting our light shine. So I thank God for today's message. I want to make sure if there's anybody else that has anything final to say before I make a few announcements for everyone. Please go forth right now in Jesus' name.
Minister Gay.
Yes.
Mother Sharon, Mother Sharon is still on the land. She can't get on, so she wants to say something.
Hold on. Let me see.
From the ear, trying to talk to speak. I said, I'll come back online.
Okay, yeah, tell Mother Shirley, go forth.
Go forth, Mother Shirley.
Mother Shirley, I was to mute you out because your phone is beeping a lot.
During the recording.
I'm very sorry about that, so go forth now.
Go forth. Are you on, Mother Shirley?
Yes, I just want to give God thanks for today's message. Just really touched my inner core, you know, because and it said, especially when Apostle Sharon was quoting the songwriter into my heart, and I'm just asking God, yes, just enter my heart and let me accept, because I know that sometimes it's just, and she was quoting like how people would say, God knows it. He knows my heart. Even if you're doing something wrong, and you just want to say, God knows, and he's gonna excuse what you're doing because he knows you. You know, and he's like, I'm, you know, a child of God. He's gonna accept what I'm doing. So I'm just giving God thanks for this message today because it's true. God, no matter what we're doing, God knows. He knows each and every one of us. But it doesn't mean that. Yes, you see that what we're doing, and I'm trying to live a Christian life or a righteous life for him. But he don't have to accept everything that I'm doing just because I say God knows me. So, you know, that it's okay for me to do things that's not pleasing and say God knows me. So I'm just giving God thanks and praises for the message that the woman of God came through with today, and it really, really touches, you know, everything that by the way of living, to know how to live the righteous way, and to know that, you know, you can't just think that God sees and what I accept, because he doesn't have to accept me. I mean, he can say I forgive, and to know that we should repent and repent daily. And I ask God to just keep me in mind to remind me to repent from anything that I'm doing that I don't think that's wrong, and that I can think it's right, but it's not keeping me in this life. I'm just giving God thanks. And to the songwriter, you know, to enter my heart, I'm just asking him to, yes, enter my heart. And know, he knows our heart, he knows our mind, I already know our thoughts. I'm just asking, that song just really touched me, to enter my heart, and stay in, you know, stay in Jesus, stay in my heart, and help us do the right thing. And I'm
Blessing God.
Thank you, Lord, for this week. For everyone that's online. This is God. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Bless God. Thank you, Mother Shirley. And, you know, I think the thing that we're hearing, people of God, the key we're hearing is accountability. You know, that's such a key thing. We have to take accountability. Because each one of us has to work out our own salvation with fear and trembling, like the Word says. We have to be accountable for our actions, for our thoughts. And you know, God is so gracious. He's getting us in that position. He wants us to be in that position because He wants to do so much for us and wants the blockages to go away because He wants us to experience that abundant life that He paid for so dearly at the cross. So I thank God for the boldness, for the honesty, for what the Holy Spirit did today. We have to give Him praise, honor, and glory in Jesus' name. And for each and every one of you in the midst, how blessed we are to have this revelation and this teaching that the Holy Ghost is so gracious, so kind, to teach us, to instruct us, to guide us, to comfort us. Thank you, Lord. And I want each and every person to know that as we are going through this new season in Him, God is doing some different things right now, so if you do dial in and the line is not available, just try back the very next day. So continue to check it. And also you have the YouTube channel available to you 24/7. So you can certainly hook it up in your home. You can put it on your desktop, on your laptop. If you have a smartphone, you can take it with you wherever you go. You can hook up a very inexpensive cable in your car from your smartphone to the audio jack, and you can listen right through the speakers of your car. You can listen to the YouTube channel, and you can continue to be encouraged and be empowered to be blessed. And as the angels that are in operation with Apostle Sharon, that the angels that have been assigned to her life keep saying that prayer, angels, work for me like you work for Apostle. We are blessed for that powerful teaching and the dispatching of angels that we received during that in the teaching during the month of completion in July. So much He's done in these last 30 days. It's amazing. The acceleration of what He's doing in the Spirit is just, I'm so grateful. Grateful to God for each and every one of us to be privileged to take part and to hear and to have our lives changed. Remember to share the channel with others, family, relatives, neighbors, whomever the Lord puts on your heart, share it. And continue putting your great testimonies and your comments and your likes on the YouTube channel. It is so helpful to others to hear because they get encouraged. They too will get empowered and strengthened because people are going through lots of situations. As I respond to them, just know that there are people around the world that are commenting on how their lives are being changed. There are messages coming from as far as Africa, all over Europe, Latin America, all different states in the United States, the Caribbean islands, everywhere. It is not just local, but we're hearing from people all over the world. And if any of you would like to bless this ministry, you can certainly do so by contacting me via the email helpforrepentanceservejesus@gmail.com. If the Lord puts it on your heart to bless the ministry monthly, whatever you pray about, you can reach me. I will correspond with you as to what to do. And I also encourage each and every one of you to continue to pray for this ministry. There are needs, you know, that the Lord knows, and we covet your prayers. We thank you for your prayers. And continue to pray for the woman of God as she's making this transition to Florida. The Lord has told her, has commissioned her as to what she's to do, as she's to take Florida. So we bless God and the world because these messages are going to the four corners of the earth. She has a heart for the nations, and know that she's a root digger. And when she prays, She will get to the root through the power and the help of the Holy Ghost and the angels that work alongside of her. So just continue to lift her up in your prayers. And as we close out this service, let us go forth and close it out. Mother Yvonne, if you could read Matthew 6, verses 9 through 15, let us all repeat after her in the mighty name of Jesus. Go forth, Mother Yvonne.
People of God, we repeat Matthew 6, verse 9 through 15, after me, bold, please. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread.
Give us this day our daily bread.
And forgive us our debts. As we forgive our debtors.
And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory.
Forever and ever, amen.
Forever and ever, amen.
Your heavenly Father will also forgive you.
Neither will your Father forgive your trespasses. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Amen.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Amen.
One other thing I wanted to say before we also close and let Apostle give the closing prayer. For anyone that you speak to about, this is not a prayer line, but this is an empowerment church that happens to meet online. So those of you know it, but just so that it goes up on the message for YouTube, very important. Because when we get together, we are a church, this is a body, and we come together to lift up the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Bless you all. Love you all in Jesus' holy name.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah. We bless the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We glorify and we thank him. And we honor him for his goodness and his mercy. People of God, just want for you all to be blessed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My God Almighty, and I just want you all to know that my God Almighty, Friday, my God Almighty service is already up. My God Almighty, I was able to put up three, my God Almighty message this morning from earlier, maybe about from 2 o'clock or... 2 o'clock this morning until, this morning out daylight. So, they're all up, people of God. So go and enjoy them in the name of Jesus Christ. As we speak about this today, the date of the 20th, 2017. May you all be blessed. May the Lord Jesus Christ bless and keep you. May his face continue to shine upon you and your family. And don't forget, people of God, continue to call my God every morning, 6 o'clock, from Monday to Friday, and you will and to know if I'm on or not, even on Sunday and 12 o'clock. God bless you all, you and your family, while my little granddaughter, DJ Naya, sing along with Don. And sing along with Nanny McCurkin, with Joshua, in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. There is no God like Jehovah. Be blessed in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. I receive it in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Glory.
Glory be to God. Thank you, Lord.
Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. so God-like Jehovah.
There's no God like my Jesus. 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 There's no God like my Jesus.
Oh God, hallelujah.
Love you, God bless you in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.